were saying there. They have an opportunity now to go to a Munster final, but they stay in the Championship, which is more important for them at this stage. Next weekend, by the way, it is Waterford and Cork at Sample Stadium and Clare versus Limerick in Ennis. I suppose we should start here on the panel with Ger Loughnane, because you had Tipperary hurting in the Championship of 2018, dead and buried a couple of weeks ago. Now, I suppose the only thing we can say about it at this stage, you were just slightly ahead of yourself.
If you just believe me, I have experience. Like, I've been here so long. All these young lads that have Twitter and all these kinds of things saying, look, man, is a so-and-so and all that. But sure, look, what I was just telling you, what anyone could see, that the energy was gone out of that Tipperary team. But, today's World Player.
Yes.
In fairness,
yes.
Now. Yes. So they came down, Gerry O'Connor had it beforehand. We all realised. Supporters, players, everybody realised today was a seminal day for Clare. Today they had to make that step forward. It looked for a long time as if they wouldn't. You know, their hurling was cumbersome, their touch was poor, they were nervous, but when it came to it, they did it. And that's all that matters.
Yeah.
They showed the heart that we haven't seen out in for 5 years. And the crucial thing was a man who epitomised everything great about him 5 years ago in 2013, Hodge Collins.
Yeah.
Come on. He scored 3 points.
Yeah.
He set up the goal. He brought a new life and energy into that forward line. And Peter Duggan, the new kid on the block, polished it off in the end. Now, there were faults in it. We'll forget about him.
Sure.
Because it was just a brilliant victory for Clare when it was most needed. And tonight, when I'm going home from here, I'm going to go through Tommy Vara and Nina and Harry. Just to remind them that the neighbours from hell are back. 15 years.